I am here to tell you a story of one of the very, very busy and renowned industrialists, Mr. Vijay Pusalkar. He came to us with the complaints of back pain, leg pain. At the same time, he used to say that his back pain, leg pain restricts his high-profile meetings, his busy schedule, and his daily activities are getting restricted. This spinal problem made him nervous because he was not able to perform with his full-fledged activities.
You know, I have led an active life most of the time, but suddenly, you know, this back pain deprived me of my normal living. I used to be a very active golfer, but unfortunately, after this pain increased to such a level, I had to completely give up golf and couldn't stand in one place, couldn't bend forward, couldn't pick up things if they fell down. So it was hampering my life. The quality of my life had deteriorated very badly.
So what was the problem? Let's see what is the normal spine, how it looks like. When I talked to him, I told Mr. Pusalkar that this is how our normal spine is. This is the lower lumbar area. We call it L1, L2, L3, L4 and L5. And this is the tailbone. One of the most important structure of this vertebral column is to protect the spinal cord, which is running from the brain down to the legs. The spinal cord carries all the functions. It carries all the signals, vital information. It carries life in your legs. It makes you walk. In his case, there was a problem at two levels, between his L4-5 and L5-S1. That is, last two levels, the nerves were getting pressed. Let's see how, what was the structure. This is the spinal cord which is running behind the vertebral column. This is L2, this is L3, this is L4, this is L5, and this is the sacrum. He had problems at 4, 5, 5S1. The discs act like a cushion. They act like a shock absorber. They take all the shocks and makes us mobile and agile. Because of his heavy traveling, because of his hard work, heavy work which he performed during his young days, and because of so many reasons, we call it as wear and tear of the disc, degenerative diseases which sets in, and the process began many years ago, which started with one level problem, what we call it as a disc herniation or the slip disc at L5S1. Mr. Pusalkar had subsequently multi-level disc herniations. There was a lumbar canal stenosis. Lumbar is the lower back, canal narrowing is a lumbar canal stenosis. Whenever he used to get up, he used to get back pain because of spondylitis. He was not able to walk for longer distance because of neurogenic claudication. That means the nerves were getting choked, they were getting squeezed, they were getting pressed, and the culprit was L3-4, L4-5 and L5-S1. Which developed subsequently. He also had a diabetes, which was the concern. He got his neurophysiological testings done, which showed the nerves were getting severely compressed and there was no neuropathy. What exactly was happening, we can see it here very well. The spinal cord, you can see, was getting squeezed, was getting pressed at multiple levels. So the disc herniation at these three levels was making the spinal cord very, very narrowed at multiple levels. The electrical signals were not reaching his feet. He was having a significant problem in performing his daily activities.
This kept on increasing. I was advised to do yoga, I was advised to Ayurveda, then there were some Chinese medicines were prescribed, I took them also, But really, that was all very temporary relief. When the pain became unbearable, I decided that I need to go to a spine surgeon, and he examined me thoroughly. And after examination, he concluded that, you know, I had damaged my L4 or L5 to a large extent, and explained to me the modern techniques used in curing such situations like mine, and with minimal invasive surgery, you know, where they take a very small cut, and I went through it.
We performed a microscopic surgery on the squeezed spinal cord. The surgery lasted less than 1 hour, and we make the spinal cord like this. This was performed through a keyhole operation. We call it as MIS, that's a minimal invasive spine surgery. Microscopic surgery delivered the best of the results. Today he is attending all his executive meetings, he is driving on his own, and he is able to perform all his daily activities.
After I underwent the operation, I was not allowed to get out of bed for about 3 days. Then on the fourth day, with some support, I was asked to take small walks in the hospital itself. And then I was discharged from the hospital after about 6 days. I was told what not to do and what I could do by the hospital staff. After about 15 days, I was allowed to do my normal activity. I was re-examined and I was allowed to do that. So it took about 1 month really to get back to normal. There were many things which you know, I was once again able to do, and I can say today that my life is considerably better and improved.
Why this case we are discussing today? Because this is a very, very common problem, because it happens because of degeneration. It happens because of wear and tear. Not every individual requires surgery. If I see 10 patients, out of 10, 8 of them, like 80% of them, do get better with medicines. But if the case is of Mr. Vijay Pusalkar, they require accurate planning, small surgical intervention, which is microscopic, to deliver the best of the result. And here we see Mr. Pusalkar, who is a very happy person today.